exactly what the colors would be. So we'll do it a little bit. I'll start adding water to the paint and blending by itself. Say these techniques that I'm using are not of my invention at all. So they've been around for years and I learned them a long time ago. The part most people don't get when they're painting with acrylic paints, which I forgot to do, is that water is your friend. You can use them sort of like a watercolor. Blend colors right on the canvas, which is what I do. I've never really used a palette to mix paints or anything. I just kind of learned to do it this way. And I learned a long time ago, so I was back in junior high, yeah, 7th grade. Changes the paint a little bit color wise, and it also blends and gives a depth. When you use a sponge technique, it'll give a depth that you really can't get just with using paint by itself. It has a transparency of colors, something that really looks pretty good. this video, so there's some parts you won't see, but I'll show you in the end what it looks like, the finished dried look, which is actually completely different from what you're looking at right now. So yeah, this is just more blending and blending and blending. Kind of gets a little tedious. This is where you kind of just clean up all the edges. You don't want any real hard edges on it. I was trying to actually put some dimension in right here, but I'm not sure if that really worked because I didn't want to put any more black as a shadow. So I also put some highlights in towards the end, which you won't see in this video. See you.